Welcome to Consumer Update. I'm Kelly Lightbourne. Palm Harbor Medical Associates serve the clinical needs for many patients. They also offer people the opportunity to participate in clinical research studies. Joining us today is Dr. Aaron Schlau, who is not only the medical director, but he's also an author. And the book you wrote is The Prescription Medical Savings Guide, right?
Correct. It was a few years ago, but basically there was a lot of cost that goes around medications. And a lot of my patients were having problems buying their prescriptions. So what I did was I pretty much took all the different medication savings programs that were out there, and I kind of cataloged them and cross-referenced it and made it into something that was easy for people to go through to find. And it's still on Amazon. I think my mom bought a copy, and a couple of my uncles and aunts bought a few copies, but it's still available.
But it has a lot of great information, it sounds like really helpful information for people that, you know, have medical needs. And obviously, we all want to save money.
Yeah, it's a good way to cut costs. I mean, medications get to be expensive, and the new, it's got to fund research and the new and drugs that are coming out. But there's, if you can't afford your medication, then it does you no good.
No, that's very true. So let's talk medicine a little bit. Let's talk about what you specialize. There's a lot of new things coming out.
Correct. Basically, I'm an internal medicine physician. So I do adult medicine. And I've been doing this since about 1985 in the Palm Harbor area. And since that time, we've been doing clinical research also. Okay. And we've been very fortunate where we've been able to do some of the breakthrough medications that are now coming to market. Mm-hmm. We've been able to be the first people in the area to be able to use it and offer it to our patients.
Wow, and I think that's a really big deal for people that are looking for other options. Mm-hmm. So they can come to you and learn about what the latest medical treatments are.
Right, because the one nice thing about clinical research is this day and age, all patients are still kept to the standard of care, where they're given the maximum dose of the medications that are out there in the market that's tolerable, and then they're compared to that to the medication itself that is being studied. So the patients are going to be monitored closely by clinical review boards, several layers of PhDs reviewing the records. And it helps tailor the medication to them and gives them opportunity on drugs that they were not able to get before.
Yeah, would normally not be able to get. And I know a lot of people, when they hear clinical studies, they're like, oh, I don't want to be a part of that. But it's not, there's been a lot of research done before it's given to your patient. So it's not like, you know, somebody's coming out and they're a guinea pig. This is stuff that works.
Right.
They're just getting cutting edge technology ahead of time.
Right. Well, there's four levels of research. And what we are doing is stage two and stage three studies.
Okay.
So they've already done some safety data. Now, during the whole time of the drug's life, even after it's in the market, there is constant feedback to the pharmaceutical companies about the safety of the medication.
Right.
But this is basically on stage three studies. It's already been through a bunch of safety data, and we try to stay on phase two, phase three studies, because you've already been proven that they're pretty safe.
No, and I think that's really important to stress. Now, what are some of the cutting edge studies that you're seeing or that you're working with?
We're pretty fortunate. We do a lot of diabetic studies and a lot of cholesterol studies. We do have some emphysema studies. Right now we're doing a particular study, which is every 6 months an implant for diabetes.
Oh, wow.
That's
a lot easier.
Yeah, basically it's an implant an implant that we put into the abdomen through a syringe, and it stays in there for 6 months. And when it's there for 6 months, it constantly releases a slow amount of medication so that the patients may require less medications while they're on it. Now, there is a potential that they might be on placebo, but they're going to be monitored, and they will also be on medication to get them to goal.
Right. Now, and that's a tiny little thing. It's got a lot of power in it.
Yeah, they use something. They use something similar right now for the treatment of for a type of birth control. So now it's branching out into other markets, and right now it's being used on a diabetic medication.
Now, what's the benefit of having this? Like, obviously, you don't have to monitor yourself as closely,
You still will need to monitor yourself. That's just good care for diabetes. You still have to watch your diet, and you still have to exercise. But what's nice about this is it gives another level of treatment that a patient has that they can possibly go on if they meet the criteria for it to work for them.
Mm-hmm. So just another option.
Just another option.
And I know people with diabetes are looking for options because it's a certain way of life, but.
Right. Well, unfortunately with diabetes, if they don't change their lifestyle and their diet and exercise, usually every medication will fail with time, usually about 2 years. This gives us another tool in our toolbox to be able to use for patients.
It must be incredible to be able to help people the way that you do. I mean, what's that like?
Well, it's fun. It's uh-huh. fun. I look at my work not as a job. I look at it as a profession that I love what I do. There are some challenges in the marketplace this day and age with insurances and healthcare in general, mm-hmm. but I like to treat my patients like family.
Well, what are some of the other like treatments that you have available at your clinic?
Well, we're basic internal medicine, so okay. we treat all types of diseases. Mm-hmm. But as far as research is concerned, we're looking for people with emphysema okay. to try them on. We're using a long-acting treatment to open up the airways.
Oh, wow.
We're doing the implant, which we're very excited about. Mm-hmm. It's been very gratifying to use the implant. We're doing a cholesterol medication, which is a once-a-month injectable wow. for people who have failed, who are not to goal with their current medication, mm-hmm. they would still be on their medication with this injection. We're doing one for chronic kidney disease. People who are diabetic have chronic kidney disease. About one out of three will have kidney disease. And this is a medication that works and hopefully will help repair the kidneys.
Well, it looks like you have your hands full. You have a lot of really exciting treatments available.
Yeah, I'm very lucky. I have a good group of coordinators that work with me, and it makes my job very easy.
Well, how do they find you? I guess that's the big question, because if you've hit on a topic for somebody, they need to be able to find you. How do they do that?
Well, we're located in Palm Harbor, which mm-hmm. is North Pinellas County. Our phone number is 727-785-4540. And if they ask for our research department, mm-hmm. they'll be transferred down to Kathy, who will help coordinate to them to the right person.
No, that's great. Now, when I come in, what is that experience like? Obviously, you're going to evaluate me and see if I fit one of these research.
Right. I mean, every research study has certain criteria okay. to enter. And they also have a certain criteria for exclusion, because we're looking for people who have certain illnesses that meet the inclusion criteria, but they're not going to be at risk because of some things that they're excluded from.
Okay.
Just like any medication, there's contraindications for medications. So what the staff will do is they'll spend an hour or so looking over your inclusion okay. criteria and make sure there's nothing that would be excluded. And from there, they'll be taken down the path to what would be appropriate for them.
No, a lot of great information for people out there searching for it. So thanks again for coming on the show.
Oh, my pleasure. Thank you so much.